The Forestry Minister admits things need to change in the industry, but is stopping short of saying companies need to pay compensation. It comes as some in the industry say consents for slash traps, big nets to stop woody debris getting into the waterways, is taking too long. Political editor Jessica Much-Mackay spoke to Stuart Nash on Q&A.
One in four jobs in Gisborne is linked to forestry, and throughout New Zealand it's nearly a $7 billion industry. But scenes like this show why many are calling for changes.
What has happened this year with two cyclones is absolutely not acceptable, hence the reason why we will look to drive change in a way that mitigates the risk of this happening again.
The government announced an inquiry on Thursday despite repeatedly saying no thanks. There have already been two reports, one in 2018 with recommendations on slash, the woody debris from forestry, and another report came back at the end of last year. Add to that a petition with 10,000 signatures.
Why now? Why not just use these other two reports that you've already got?
Well, actually, Jess, a whole lot of the recommendations out of those reports have already been implemented.
Things like planting natives and harvesting smaller chunks rather than a whole hillside. But slash traps, which are like wire nets to stop trunks torpedoing down the hill, require resource consent.
We tried, as a company, Aratu tried to get the technology installed from early 2018. So we spent 4 years on it and a lot of money and consultant time, but weren't able to meet those final hurdles. So ironically, just before Christmas, we did put the white flag up.
The Greens say three quarters of the industry is foreign owned, and so they should help councils pay for broken bridges and farmers for damaged crops.
They are wealthy companies. The Tiong family, Malaysian-based, owns companies like Earnslaw One, substantial land holdings and substantial wealth in these companies.
They do have an obligation to act as good citizens. Of that, there is no doubt.
And it's so intertwined with how many people are engaged in rural industries in New Zealand in terms of how you transition out without damaging the local economy.
This latest review only covers Tairāwhiti, but the Minister says it could be applied to other places.
I'm not an apologist for the forest sector. As far as I'm concerned, it doesn't matter who owns the forest.
So if you're not an apologist, why not bring in changes then? Why not compel them to act?
This is exactly what this review is about.
That review is due back in April. Jessica Much-Mackay, One News.